that because of COVID-19, we all have to maintain social distance. So, with the means of this video, I am going to teach you Sanskrit subject. So, before we start any study, you must have to keep book in your hand. I want to tell you what we will going to learn. Students, you have to open page number 29, okay? Chapter number 8, Kagasya Chapter. Another thing is that before we start this chapter, it's our rules to revise a little bit what we learned in last session. Okay. Now, on my right side, you can see I have done some points which we have to revise first. Then we will go ahead on another new chapter. Okay. So, see, revised topic we learned in last session. Chapter number 7. Its title was there, Karo Tu. What it means? Its meaning is there. Karo Tu means let's do. It's a one type of participle. So let's do here. Okay. In that chapter, we learned different types of characters like Sachi, Vedant, Divya, Meera, Vivek, Kapila, Mayura, Nisha. Okay. And I have already told in last sessions, students, for exam, you have to know which types of activity they are following. So here I have just tried to write this activity. So see, Sachi. Sachi activity means playing. Sachi is playing. Vedant. Vedant is reading. Means Vedanta Patana. Next, Divya. Divya. Divya is writing. In Sanskrit, Divya Likati. Okay. Meera. Meera is singing. In Sanskrit, Meera speaking, singing, sorry, means Gayatri. Next, Viveka. Viveka looking. Means Vivek is looking. Viveka Pashya. Kapi means throwing. Means Kapi is throwing. Shipati. Mayura listening. Mayur is listening. In Sanskrit, Mayura Shruti. Next, Nisha. Nisha is speaking. Means Nisha Vadati in Sanskrit. Okay? That's concept we learned in last session. So, we have to go ahead on another new chapter. Its title is there, Kakasya Chaturthiyam. Okay? Okay, first of all, we have to understand its a title. Okay, then I will say short story, what is there in short. Okay, see, Kakasya Chaturthiyam. Here, you can see it's a case form. Okay, the main word is Kaka, and another, this here you can see it's following the apostrophe S. Kakasya means of crow, and Chaturthiyam means favorite. Okay, Chaturthiyam and Chaturthiyam. Means here we have to follow its adjective form. So clever energy. So your title is there, Kakasya Chaturthiyam means clarity of crow. Understood? Now see. First of all, I want to read this chapter. So you pay attention in your book. So easily you can get how the reading of this chapter happened. See in your book, page number 29. एकस्मिन् वने एकः वटवृक्षः अस्ति तत्र काकः वसति काकस्य पत्नी शावकीः सह तत्रैव वसति तस्य वृक्षस्य अद्य कोटरे एकः सर्पः वसति ओके दिस इज द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ That's you can see in your book. Now second line, see, second paragraph means Ekada kaka bharyaya saha ahartham. Okay, here I am reading like this ahartham. Why ma? Because here upside you can see God. Okay, so ma pronounce ahartham kachati tada sarvaha ekam shavakam kadati. Next, yada kaka. आगच्छति पश्यति च एकः श्रावकः निदे नास्ति। वृक्षस्य अद्यः सर्पं दृष्ट्वा काकः वदति, अहो एषः दुष्टसर्पः सावकं खादति, किञ्चित् उपायं करोमि इति विचिन्त्य काकः नदीं प्रति गच्छति। नेक्स्ट्, तत्र राजकुमारी स्नानं करोति, तस्याः सुवर्णहारः नदीतीरे अस्ति। चतुरः काकः सुवर्णहारम् अपहरति। काकः सुवर्णहारं कोदरस्य अन्तः क्षिपति। सैनिकः काकस्य पृष्ठे आगच्छति, कोदरे सुवर्णहारं सर्पं च पश्यति। सः चिन्तयति, अहो प्रथमं सर्पं मारयामि, अनन्तरं हारं नयामि। ओके, इट्स अ डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट सेंटेंस, सो दैट्स यू हैव टू नो ग्रामर टॉपिक ऑफ इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट। इन संस्कृत ऑल्सो वी कैन से दैट इट्स अ डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। सो हियर यू कैन सी डबल इनवर्टेड कॉमा, अहो प्रथमं सर्पं मारयामि, अनन्तरं हारं नयामि। नेक्स्ट, सैनिकः सर्पं मारयति, हारं नयति। काकः वदति, अहो सर्पः मृतः, अधुना सुखेन वसामि। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द रीडिंग ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। नाउ लेट्स आई वांट टू टेल यू शॉर्ट स्टोरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। व्हाट इज देयर इन दिस चैप्टर, लिसन। हियर देयर इज वन फॉरेस्ट। इन दिस फॉरेस्ट देयर इज ए बनियन ट्री। हियर ऑन बनियन ट्री lived a crow. A crow lived with his wife and kids. Another thing is that under this tree in the hall, a one snake also living. Another, what happens is, once crow and his wife ready to find food. So they live that place. At that time, a snake ate one kid of crow. After some time, what happened? When crow came back and see one kid is not present in the nest, so immediately he saw a one snake under a tree. So he thought that surely this snake ate my kid. Oh, then he said, oh, this snake is a very big one, cruel one. So by any way, I have to kill it. So that I have to think about. So after deep thinking, crow flew away at the bank of the river. At the bank of the river, one princess was taking bath in the river, and her golden necklace is there on the bank of the river. Crow was very, very clever, so that's why he took that golden necklace and flew away. After that, what happened? He flew away near that bunny tree, and after reaching there, he threw that golden necklace into the hall where a snake was living. One soldier, here who you can see picture of soldier, okay? One soldier, one observing everything, so that's why he also followed to the crow. When this soldier reached near that money entry, at that time he saw golden necklace into the hall, and he also saw snake into the hall too. So he decided that, let's first of all I have to kill this snake and then have to take this golden necklace. So after that, what happens to this, you know, soldier, one who killed that snake and then the concept whatever you will learn in this story. Okay. So next we have to transfer this and you will see in your book. See. First line. Eka asmina vane. Eka vata vusha asti. Eka asmina vane means in one forest. Eka vata vusha asti. Eka means one or article A. Vata vusha means banyan tree and asti is following the present tense. So the line is happen like this. There is a banyan tree in the forest. Next time. Tatra kaka vasati. Tatra means there. Kaka means crop and vasati. It's following the present tense that you can see here. T. Okay. Third person singular form. Kaka, it's a third person singular form. So here T you can see in your book. Okay. Tatra kaka vasati means present tense. So a crow lives there. Next. Kakasya patni savakehe saha tatreva vasati. Kakasya patni, kaka means crow. And here you can see, I already told apostrophe S. So crow's wife. Savakehe saha. Savak means kids. And saha means with. Tatreva vasati means lived there. So the whole translate happen like this. Crow's wife lives there with kids. Tasya vrukshasya adhah kotare ekah sharpah vasati. Tasya vrukshasya means at that banyan tree. Adhah means under. Kotare means in the hall. Ekah sharpah vasati means living one snake. Now how the transfer happened this? See, one snake, one who was living in the hall of that tree. This is the concept of Tasterasuras. Okay? Now another para. See, ekada kakah maryaya sah aharam gacchati. Ekada means once, kakah means crow, maryaya sah aharam gacchati. Maryaya sah means with wife, aharam gacchati means is going for food. So the translation like this: once crow went for the food with his wife. Tada sarpaha ekam savaka khadati. Tada means at that time. Sarpaha means snake. Ekam means one or article A. Savaka khadati means eating to the kid. So the translation happened like this. At that time, a snake, one who ate one kid. Put stop next. Yada kakaha agarchati pasyati cha. Yada. Yada means when. Kakah agachati means crow came. Pasyati cha means and show. Means two action is going here. One is agachati and another is pasyati. So cha you can see at last. In between we have to put that. So see, when crow came and see. Ekah savakah nide nasti means one kid is not present in the nest. Vrukshasya adhyah sarpah drashtva kakah vadati. Vrukshasya adhyah means under the tree. Sarpam drashtva. Sarpam drashtva means seeing the or looking or watching. Watching the snake. Kakah vadati means crow is speaking. The whole translation happens like this. A snake, one who is present under a tree, by looking it, crow spoke or crow is speaking. Comma, singular comma you can see. Aho means oh. Esa dushta sarpa savakam khadati. Esa means this. We already learnt. Okay, in the already previous chapters. Esa means this. Dushta sarpa means weak snake. Savakam khadati means eating to the kid. So here crow is speaking that oh, this weak snake ate my kids. Kinchit upayam karoti. Kinchit means something, okay, little bit. Upayam karoti means have to do. So here he is telling me, let's, I have to do something. Iti vichintya kakaha nadim prati gacchati. Iti vichintya means after thinking this, kakaha nadim prati, crow, nadim prati means to river. Prati you can see means to, preposition have to the whole transmitter one of this line is that after thinking this, crop went to the bank of the river. Next. Tatra Rajkumari Snanam Karoti. Tatra means there. And Rajkumari Snanam Karoti means princess. Snanam is bathing and Karoti is following the present tense means three. So translate it like this. Princess is doing bath there. Tasya Suvarnahara Naditira Asti. Tasya and Tasya, these types of word you will learn in Sanskrit. Here Tasya used for female form. Tasya used for male form. So, let's see. Tasya Suvarnahara means her golden necklace. Naditira Asti means it is present at the bank of the river. Okay. So her golden necklace is at the bank of the river or present at the bank of the river. Chatur Kaka Suvarnaharam Apaharati. Chatur Kaka means clever girl. Suvarnaharam means golden necklace. Apaharati. Apaharati means apaharam. Okay. Means take away. So here the clever girl took away. Here past tense used because apaharati. So clever girl took away a golden necklace. Next, page number 30. See, kakah suvarnaharam kodarashya antahashya. Kakah means crow, suvarnaharam means golden necklace, kodarashya antah means into the hall, shipati means is throwing. Already you learned in 7th chapter, shipati means throwing. So here kodarashya antah shipati means is throwing into the hall. So whole translation happened like this. Crow threw away golden necklace into the hall. Sainikaha kakasya pushti agachati. Sainikaha means soldier. Kakasya pushti means behind a crow. Agachati means came over. So here translated one. A soldier, one who came over or came after a crow. Kotare suvarnaharam sarpam cha pashyati. Kotare means into the hall. Suvarnaharam means golden necklace. Sarpam means snake. Cha will come in the between. Pashyati means looking. So here translated like this. He saw a golden necklace and a snake into the hall. So chintayati. Chintayati means he thought. Oh, pratham sarpam marayami. Anantaram haram nayami. Means direct indirect following here. So see. Oh, let's first I will kill snake. Anantaram means after that. Haram nayami means after that I will take necklace. Haram. Here you will not use golden necklace. Here only haram word you can see. So that's why necklace you have to use there. Okay. So oh, first I will kill snake and after that I will take necklace. Last paragraph. Sainik sarpam marayati haram nayati. A soldier, one who killed, took the snake and take away necklace. Next, kakavati. Crow is speaking. Aho. Oh. Sharpah mrutah. Means a snake died. Aduna sukhina vasami. Aduna means now. Sukhina means happily. And vasami means living. Means now I am living happily. This is the concept of this chapter, students. Okay, so let's, according to our chapter, we have to revise as question answer. See what we have here. Vata vruksha putra asti. Vata vruksha putra asti. Putra means where. Asti present tense. Vata vruksha putra asti. Vata vruksha vane asti. Vrukshasya kotare kaha asti. Rukshashya kotare kaha means who? Vasati means living. Rukshashya kotare sarpaha vasati. Kaha ekam sarvakam khadati. Sarpaha ekam sarvakam khadati means kaha will go away. And here you have to write. Okay? Sarpaha ekam sarvakam khadati. Rukshashya adhyaha sarpam drashtva kaha kaha kim vadati. kids means chatu, okay? Khadati. Okay, next Suvarna Uttar means golden name is Uttar means bell. Asti means bell. Suvarna Uttar is Asti. Next, Sainikaha Cooperative Asti. Here two answers we get right here. Porter also is the right answer. And here Aditya also is the right answer. See next, Sainikaha Cooperative Asti. Sainikaha Cooperative Suvarnahar cha sarpam asya. Okay, so let's, this is the concept that we learned in this chapter, and after this you have to keep in your mind mi vama si thamata and ti thamata anti. So let's revise this chapter at your home, and whatever exercise given in your book, that's you have to write in your notebook. Take care. Thank you.